aggravating circumstances are those which... Hello mga kakognizans, welcome back to my channel, and for today's video, I will discuss about the concepts of aggravating circumstances and the different kinds of aggravating circumstances. This is the first part of our discussion under Article 14 of the Revised Penal Code. In fact, I divided this article into three parts because Article 14 of the Revised Penal Code has 21 paragraphs to be discussed of. Now, what is or what do you mean by aggravating circumstances? Aggravating circumstances are those which, if attendant in the commission of the crime, serve to increase the penalty without, however, exceeding the maximum penalty provided by law for the offense. So going back to Article 64 of the Revised Penal Code, based on my previous discussion about the rule on applicability of divisible penalties or the rule on applicability of a penalty having three periods, which is the minimum, medium, and maximum. So kung ato to siyang hinumduman, first rule niya, under Article 64, niya na siya nga, no mitigating, no aggravating, the penalty to be imposed is in its medium period. And also, let us also relate this Article 64 to Article 76. Article 76 of the Revised Penal Code provides the medium and maximum period based on the entirety of the penalty to be imposed. See, for example, on the crime of homicide, which is the penalty is reclusion temporal as prescribed by law. So, based on Article 76, iyahan lang i-provide ang iyang minimum, medium, and maximum. Diba, ang entire punishment or penalty sa homicide is 12 years and 1 day to 20 years. That is the entirety of the penalty. So, kung imong i-apply ang Article 76, mao na tong ang iyang minimum period is 12 years and 1 day to 14 years and 8 months. Ang iyang medium period is nasa 14 years, 8 months and 1 day to 17 years and 4 months. Ang iyang maximum period is nasa 17 years, 4 months and 1 day to 20 years. So mao na siya gipasabot sa Article 76. Ngano ako siyang giapil? Kay para mahibaw-an nato ang iyahang minimum, medium, and maximum. Now, maghimot ang illustration. At ang yari sa commission of the crime served to increase the penalty. So, going back to Article 64, di ba, based on the, I think that is third paragraph under Article 64, nganingana siya kung naay usa ka aggravating circumstance in the commission of the crime, ang imuhang i-apply is in its maximum period. Tong sabton. See, for example, there was a crime committed and the crime is homicide. Since the crime committed was homicide, the penalty prescribed by law is reclusion temporal. So, reclusion temporal. Now, kay reclusion temporal man, ang akong giingon is naa siya'y aggravating circumstance. There is one aggravating circumstance during the commission of the crime of homicide. Now, atong i-apply ang Article 64. Unsay giingon sa Article 64? Kung naa'y aggravating circumstance, i-apply nimo ang penalty in its maximum period. Therefore, i-apply na to si aggravating circumstance. Aggravating circumstance, if attendant in the commission of the crime, naa'y attendant, o saka aggravating, ha? O saka aggravating, serve to increase the penalty. Ni-increase na sa penalty, kaya na may aggravating. Diba, ganihan, niingon ko, no aggravating, no mitigating, medium. So, kay medium man siya, diara siya, stay dito sa medium, ha? Now, niingon ko, na-aggravating. Kaya na-aggravating, mu-increase na ta to its maximum penalty. Ha? One aggravating, apply ka og to maximum penalty. Dili ka pwede nga mulapas sa reclusion temporal which is prescribed by law. Kaya ang gi-prescribe by law is reclusion temporal man, therefore ang imuhang i-impose nga penalty is reclusion temporal in its maximum period. Nasabtan. Kay niingon man ta sa aggravating circumstances nga i-increase nimo ang penalty. Okay, I hope you understand. So atong i-contrast between the two sa no mitigating, no aggravating. Ang resulta is medium period. One aggravating, ang resulta is minimum. Therefore, makita nimo from medium to maximum ni increase ang penalty. Kuha. Now, arita sa iyang second nga pasabot sa iyang definition. However, exceeding to increase the penalty without, however, exceeding the maximum of the penalty provided by law for the offense. See, for example, the crime committed was homicide. And there were four aggravating circumstances. Naiopat ka aggravating circumstances nga present during the commission of the crime. So kay 4 man, sumingon ka, ay siguro kay kumingon og 1 aggravating, maximum man siya. So magpuno ko, another 1, so minimum na ko, reclusion temporal, o perpetua, kay may sunod, reclusion perpetua, another 1, para mo tulo, another 1, para mo 4. But remember, ang reclusion perpetua is indivisible penalty. Ha? Indivisible penalty based on Article 63. Therefore, diha na siya mo stop sa reclusion temporal in its maximum period. And in fact, dili lang kay tungod sa indivisible ang reclusion perpetua, maos na siya ang rule in the application of the penalty in case of there are more than 1 aggravating circumstances. Kinahanglan ka on its maximum penalty on the penalty prescribed by law. Unsa may prescribed by law sa homicide, reclusion temporal. Bisan pag upat pa na ka-aggravating circumstances ang present, ha? Dili na siya nimo pwedeng i-reclusion perpetua. Diha ra ka kutob sa unsa man, sa maximum penalty of reclusion or maximum period of reclusion temporal for the crime of homicide. Nga naman, it is very clear under the definition of aggravating circumstances nga niingon siya, without, however, exceeding the maximum penalty provided by law for the offense. So, dili ka mo exceed. Unsa may iyang i-provide, di ba, reclusion temporal? Therefore, on its maximum period ka, di ka pwedeng mulapas. Okay, I hope you understand sa definition sa aggravating circumstance. Now, let us proceed to the basis on the aggravating circumstance. The basis is that they are based on the greater perversity of the offended party manifested in the commission of the felony. First, by motivating power itself. So, unsa may nakapamotivate niya nga ni-commit siya sa krimen. So, say for example, under paragraph 11, of Article 14, niana siya nga the crime committed kuno, it's because of by giving of price, reward, or promise. So, kay tungod kay gitagaan siya og price, reward, o gipramisan siya, nga tagaan siya og kwarta or any material things nga mo compensate sa iyahang gihimo nga krimen, then maunay nakapamotivate niya to commit a crime. Since maunay nakapamotivate niya to commit a crime because of the greater perversity, then ma-considered ni mo siya as one of the basis in the commission of the crime para imo siyang i-apply ang aggravating circumstances. Because of the greater perversity in the commission of the crime. Muna siya, example sa motivating power. Now, place of commission. See, for example, na-commit ang crime in the dwelling of the victim. Na, that is provided under paragraph 3 of Article 14 of the Revised Penal Code. Paragraph 3, nga na-commit ang crime in the dwelling of the offended party. Of course, because of the greater perversity in the commission of the crime and in the place of the offended party, then mo aggravate na sad siya. Ha, mao na siya murag matawag nato nga nakakommit siya og krimen, and in fact imong i-apply on the to increase the penalty. It's because of the place of the commission of the crime. Okay. Next is the means and ways employed. So, kining means and ways employed is provided under paragraph 12. Paragraph 12 of Article 14 of the Revised Penal Code nga during the commission of the crime daw, nigamit siya og fire, poison, or explosion para i-consummate ang iyahang intended crime to be committed. So, nigamit siya mga pamaagi. Si for example, in the crime of arson, imong gidagkutan, nigamit ka og kayo para masunog ang balay. So, that is considered as the means and ways employed in the commission of the crime. Next is the time. So, nakakommitted ka og krimen, yan ay aggravating circumstances, it's because of the time. Dili kay alas 3, alas 4 ha, but on the situation, si for example, earthquake. Si for example, na ay mga fire, inundation, na yung mga ingonan ng mga calamities or kalamidad, dayon nangawat ka, imong gikuan ang pagkakataon, imong gi mura o gigamit ang panahon aron nga maka-commit ka sa imuhang krimen nga igustong buhaton. So meaning there was a greater perversity sa pag-commit nimo sa pagpangawat kay tungod sa time nga nahitabo anang adlawa, tungod kay na earthquake, tungod kay na sunog, so nangawat ka. So mao na siya ang gitawag nato nga basis on the greater perversity of the offender nga ning commit siya sa sakrimen. Next is the personal circumstances of the offenders or the offended party. So ang iyang personal circumstances diyang gipasabot nato is provided under Article 9. Article 9 of the Article 14 paragraph 9 paragraph 9 of Article 14 of the Revised Penal Code. Niya na siya that the accused is a recidivist. So personal circumstances na siya of the offender. Kinsa din na siya recidivist? Si recidivist is a person na siya nga nakakommit o krimen niya while on trial of one crime, he was previously convicted of a crime embraced on the same title of the code. Si for example, on trial siya sa crime of physical injuries but he was previously convicted of a crime of homicide. Kung imo siyang tan-aon sa Revised Penal Code, physical injuries and homicide is a crime against person. So meaning to say, nag-embraced siya on the same title of the code, therefore, considered siya as a recidivist. Therefore, ang mahitabo is, mo-aggravate na sad ang iyahang penalty, i-increase nimo ang iyahang penalty because of the personal circumstances of the person. So, I hope you understand those basic concepts of aggravating circumstances. Now let us proceed to the four kinds of aggravating circumstances. First is the generic aggravating circumstances or the ordinary aggravating circumstances. Those that can apply generally or generally apply to all crimes. Example, dwelling, nighttime, recidivism. And in fact, it's provided under Article 14 of the Revised Penal Code, paragraph 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 19, 14, 18, 19, 20, except by means of motor vehicles, are generic circumstances. So, ma-consider nimo is majority or halos tanan nga mga circumstances provided under Article 14 is considered as a generic aggravating circumstances or ordinary aggravating circumstances. This generic or aggravating circumstances can be offset. Ha, pwede na siya nimo ma-offset to ordinary mitigating circumstances. Katuganing niyo tanga kung naay mitigating naay aggravating, kung pareha siya, for example, ang weight of the circumstances, pwede siya nimong walaon. Ha? Pwede nimong i-offset. Muna siya, pwede niya nimong ma-offset si generic aggravating circumstances. And, when we talk of generic aggravating circumstances, di ba, ma-offset siya, ang imuhasang pag-increase sa penalty ani is hantod lang sa iyahang maximum period. Pareha sa kong giingon ganiha, on the crime of homicide, ang iyahang penalty is reclusion temporal. So, kay nga na present sa gikumit ang krimen during night time. So, imong i-apply is kutob lang ka sa maximum period of reclusion temporal. Na ay night time, yan ay dwelling, na ay recidivism. Again, gibalik na ako ganiha based on the definition nga ayaw nimo or ayaw ipalapas sa penalty prescribed by law. Okay? Muna na yung pinaka-importante diya sa generic or ordinary aggravating circumstance. Now let us proceed to specific aggravating circumstance or special aggravating circumstances. Those that apply only to particular crimes. Meaning to say, selected ng mga krimen lang ang pwedeng masudlan sa specific aggravating circumstances. From the word specific, muna particular. Unlike ganiya sa generic, so general. Mura siya og kinatibukan or mostly of the crimes is pwede nimo ma-apply si generic aggravating circumstance. While when we talk of specific, is kana lang siya nga mga offenses, kana lang siya nga mga crimes imo ma-apply pwede. See, for example, on the crime of ignominy in crime against chastity. Ignominy in the crimes against chastity. What is an ignominy? An ignominy, it is a moral suffering. Moral suffering means, ang imuha barong loved ones or asawa nimo is gilugos sa imuhang atubangan. Gipatanaw ka. So, mo result siya into ignominy. So, kay na may ignominy in a crime against, for example, in a crime against chastity, then, i-apply nimo ang specific aggravating circumstance. Sabtan. Now, in the case of cruelty and treachery, umiyong cruelty mo na si physical suffering. Physical suffering, meaning to say, gikulata ka diyan pamayo, gipaantos ka, or gilaygay ka, o sa ka gipatay. Gikurinti ba ka, or ang imuha, gisigihag ko ang kurinti, hantod ka mamatay. So, that act is considered as a cruelty because ning suffer o physical suffering ang usa ka biktima, ni inflict ang offender of physical suffering ngadto sa biktima. Therefore, makonsider na sad siya as a specific aggravating circumstances in a crime against person. So, in Article 14, the circumstances in paragraph number 3 except dwelling, kay gigamit mo nato ganiha ang paragraph 3 sa generic aggravating circumstance sa dwelling. So, karon sa specific except dwelling na sad. Paragraph 15, paragraph 16, 17, and 21 are specific aggravating circumstances. So, pangutana, sir, ang specific aggravating circumstance can be offset to an ordinary mitigating circumstance, just like with the generic aggravating circumstance? The answer is no. You cannot offset specific aggravating circumstance into ordinary mitigating circumstance. Okay, let us proceed to qualifying aggravating circumstance. Qualifying aggravating circumstance means that those act that change the nature of the crime. Meaning to say, change the nature of the crime, mausab. Mausab ang usa ka krimen nga gihimo sa offender. See, for example, alibusya or treachery. Or even in premeditation, qualifies the killing of a person to murder. Article 248 enumerates the qualifying aggravating circumstance which qualify the killing of a person to murder. Now, say for example, change the nature of the crime. The crime committed was, say for example, unlawful killing of a person. Di ba mayong kag unlawful killing of a person? That is homicide. Pero kung pananglitan ang qualifying circumstances provided under Article 248 from paragraph 1 to paragraph 6 is musulod na siya. Say for example, there was treachery in the commission of the crime, then musulod na ang murder. That is why niingon siya nga change the nature of the crime from homicide to murder. Mao na siya ha, change the nature of the crime. Unlike sa generic aggravating circumstance ganiha, nihatag kag penalty or ni-increase ang penalty but within sa iyang period from medium to minimum, from medium to maximum. I mean, from medium to maximum, mo'y gi-increase niya sa generic aggravating. While in qualifying aggravating, ang iyang gi-increase is the penalty itself. Why? Because from homicide, nahimo man siyang murder. Ang murder is reclusion perpetua. Therefore, ang iyang giusab, not only the crime itself, but also the penalty nga gidala sa usa ka krimen nga iyang gihimo. Provided nga, of course, musulod ang qualifying circumstances nga gihatag sa murder, which is Article 248. But mao ni siya inyohang itimanan. Kung panaklitan in a situation where the qualifying circumstances nga makita nimo sa 248 and of course makita sad nimo sa Article 14 is wala nimo na alleged sa information, ha, wala nabutang ha, for example na information but wala nimo nabutang ang treachery dito na nabantayan during trial na uy naman siya treachery during the commission of the crime pero wala man na alleged sa information, so unsay buhaton nimo? Ma-qualifying pa ba na siya nimo para ang homicide mahimo murder? The answer is no. So, dili na ka pwede, ana mo, apply sa qualifying aggravating circumstances. Nganiwan, wala man nimo na allege sa information. Since wala nimo na allege sa information, ang mahitabo ana karon nga naa may treachery during the commission of the crime, himo na siyang i-considered as a generic aggravating circumstance. But the penalty is still reclusion temporal in its maximum period. Nga naman, wala man nimo na change ang nature of the crime, which is homicide, nga para mahimo nimo og murder. Kaya nga naman, wala man nimo gi-allege sa information. Ah, wala nimo na allege sa information ang qualifying circumstances sa murder. So, muna siya. I hope you understand about qualifying aggravating circumstances. Now, let us proceed to inherent aggravating circumstance. These inherent aggravating circumstances are those that must of necessity accompany the commission of the crime. Pasabot ani niya, nagkuyog na nadaan. Ha? Gikuyog na nadaan during the commission of the crime. See, for example, evident premeditation on the crime of robbery, theft, staffa, adultery, and concubinage. So, na may evident premeditation, di na ka pwede mo ingon nga, ay, ako na siyang ipa-increase ang penalty. Kay there was an evident premeditation during the commission of the crime. Ayaw, kay nga naman, nakakuyog na siya daan. Ha? Pag ino pa, nagpilit na ang kana siyang requisites to make or to perpetrate the crime of adultery or the crime of concubinage. See, for example, under paragraph 12 of article 14, katong niyunta ni gamit siya means and employed siya og fire para makumit ang arson. Diba kung walay kayo, of course, dili nimo makumit ang crime of arson. Therefore, makonsider nimo as a company na ang kayo para mo result into arson. Therefore, makonsider nimo siya as an inherent aggravating circumstances. Now, karon unsay effects sa inherent aggravating circumstance. This inherent aggravating circumstances, dili ni siya makapa-increase sa penalty. Sir, unsay purpose nga nung ningon man siya inherent aggravating circumstance? Gibutang lang siya sa inherent aggravating circumstance as being one of the kinds of aggravating circumstance is for you to or for us to determine those classes nga maingon ta nga ay kana siya inherent, ay kana siya special, ay kana siya qualifying, but it does not increase the penalty. And in fact, under article 62 of the revised penal code, second paragraph, the same rule shall apply with respect to any aggravating circumstance inherent in the crime. So inherent in the crime, so for example, ang kayo gigamit sa pagkumit sa arson, inherent sa pagkumit sa arson ang kayo. Imong gihiloan, poison, gihiloan nimo ang usa ka tawo, dayon wala nimo na kayang poison, pwede na nimong i-constitute into murder. Basta imong na-allege sa information, pwede ka musod sa qualifying. Now, wala nimo siya na qualify, wala nimo na-allege sa information. Now, imong iyantang gamiton as ang gamiton nimo as generic aggravating ang poison. Pero initanaw, uy, ang poison naaman siya sa means employed nga gigamit ang poison para makumit ang pagpatay. Therefore, inherent siya. Kay inherent man siya in the commission of the crime, naka-accompany man siya in the commission of the crime, pwede na ko siyang gamiton nga aray sa article 62 or paragraph 2 nga mudagan ko sa paragraph 1 nga niingon ang paragraph 1 nga the penalty therefore shall not be taken into account for the purpose of increasing the penalty. So klaro ta. Ha? Kining inherent aggravating circumstance does not increase the penalty. Ha? Dili makapa-increase sa penalty. Nga naman unsay imong rason? It's because the aggravating circumstances present in the commission of the crime is already part in the commission thereof. Accompany na siya, meaning gapilit na siya daan para makonsumit ang usa ka krimen. Question: are there aggravating circumstances which do not increase the penalty? The answer is yes. First is which is themselves constitute a crime. Paragraph 12, Article 14 of the RPC, katawang gisigig mention about arson, about poison, and about explosion na ipanggamit in the commission of the crime. Next is included by law in defining a crime. So say for example, under Article 299 of Book 2 of the revised penal code, robbery on an inhabited house. So nangawat. Yan, nangawat siya. But ang kinisiyang requisites in the commission of the crime under 299 is makita sad nimo under paragraph 18 and 19 of Article 14 of the aggravating circumstances. Therefore, para makumit nimo ang crime na robbery in an inhabited house, mauna siya nag-define niya. In which kanang pag-define niya is makita nimo sa paragraph 19 and 18. Therefore, inherent siya. Kay inherent man siya, dili na nimo siya i-increase ang penalty prescribed by law. kay nanay nakabutang daan nga penalty. Okay, nasabtan. Ayaw pag-increase na niya. Next is inherent aggravating circumstances. Of course, this inherent aggravating circumstances, kato na siyang di-provide under Article 62, Paragraph 2 in relation to Paragraph 1 of the Revised Penal Code. Now, as a recap of the four kinds of aggravating circumstances, generic, applied to generally to all crimes, can be offset to mitigating circumstances. Specific, cannot be offset to ordinary mitigating circumstances and apply only to particular crimes. Qualifying circumstances change the nature and name of the crime. See, for example, from homicide to murder. Pinaka-importante is imuhang ma-allege in the information. Otherwise, kung dili nimo ma-allege sa information at tunay mo buntayan sa trial na, sa court na, din imo na siyang gamiton as a generic aggravating circumstances. But there is a big difference between the penalty to be imposed. Kay kung yung generic, again, ang imuhang i-apply is maximum period to the penalty imposed by law. Whereas kung maingon ka o qualifying aggravating circumstances change the name of the nature from homicide to murder, of course, the penalty is reclusion perpetua kung murder na siya. Now, ang pangutan na, qualifying circumstances can be offset to ordinary mitigating? The answer is no. Ha? Dili ka pwede maka-offset sa qualifying circumstances to ordinary mitigating circumstances. Ha? And lastly, the inherent aggravating circumstances, kung yung tag-inherent, accompany, ha, necessity na siya, necessary in the commission of the crime, therefore, dili na ka magpa-increase sa ihang penalty is provided under Article 62 of the Revised Penal Code. And I hope you understand about the basic concepts and of course, the four kinds of aggravating circumstances. See you on Part 2 for the continuation of Paragraph 1 to 21 of aggravating circumstances, but on the next discussion, I will elaborate more on paragraph on each paragraph as defined by Article 14 in order for you to understand more about this Article 14 of the Revised Penal Code. And thank you for watching and God bless us all.